Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are discussing about programming in C. So here we are discussing about variables in C language and how we define and how we initialize the values. And similarly, we also learn about what is constant. So today we are discussing about variables and constants. So variables. A variable is nothing but a name given to a storage area that other programs can manipulate. Simply, a variable is nothing but a name given to a storage area that our programs can manipulate. Simply, I can say that. So let us assume this is the memory location. When I am defining int a, automatically the memory location variable automatically assigned to a, and a is equal to 20, the value is stored here. So this is the way we are doing allocating a name to the memory address is called a variable. Each variable in C has a specific type which determines the size and layout of the variable's memory. The range of values that can be stored within that memory and the set of operations that can be applied to the variable. Note, rules for creating variables is similar to identifiers, but variables and identifiers are not same. So next, a variable definition tells the compiler where and how much storage to create for a variable. So very, very important, the compiler where and how much storage to create for the variable. A variable definition specifies a data type and contains a list of one or more variables of that type as follows. Data type variable list, data type variable name is equal to value. We can represent any one. So here int I comma j comma k, we defined three variables of type integer. Second one, char c comma ch. C and ch are the two variables of type character. F and salary are the two variables of type float. Here d is equal to 3 and f is equal to 5. We are initializing, defining definition and also initializing the values. Similarly, byte also same and character also same. Let us look into small things. So the first part, int a comma b, int c, float c are the variable definition. We initialize the values already defined variables. A is equal to 10, b is equal to 20, c is equal to a plus b. So we are printing the value of c. Okay. Similarly, f is we assigned some calculation and it returns some value. That value also stored in f and we printed it. So this is the way we are defining and initializing of variables. So now there are two kinds of expressions in C, L value and R value. So expressions that refer to a memory location are called L value expressions. An L value may appear as either the left hand or right hand side of an assignment. R value, the term R value refers to a data value that is stored at some address in memory. An R value is an expression that cannot have a value assigned to it, which means an R value may appear on the right hand side but not on the left hand side of an assignment. So now, difference between identifiers and variables. Identifiers are the name given to a variable or a function, while variable is used to name a memory location which stores data. An identifier can be a variable, but not all identifiers are variables. All variable names are identifiers. Here the example, int is, this is a variable, this is the function. So here both are variables. The second topic is constants. Constants refer to fixed values that the program may not alter during its execution. Constants refer to fixed values that the program may not alter during its execution. These fixed values are also called as literals. Constants can be of any of the basic data types like an integer constant, a floating constant, a character constant, or a string constant. There are enumeration constants as well. Constants are treated just like regular variables, except that their values cannot be modified after their definition. Integer literals are also called as constants. An integer literal can be a decimal, octal, or hexadecimal constant, a prefix with space, the base or radix. 0 small x or 0 capital X for hexadecimal, 0 for octal, and nothing for decimal. An integer literal can also have a suffix that is a combination of U and L for assigning unsigned and long respectively. The suffix can be uppercase or lowercase and can be in any order. So these are the 215 U means unsigned, 0x means already we know that hexadecimal value, 0 means it is an octal, 03 this is cannot illegal, these two are illegal, okay. 8 is okay, 8 is not octal, so this is not illegal, and we are using UU, we cannot use it. So here also we mentioned 85 is decimal, 0231 is octal, and 0x4b is hexadecimal, 30 is integer, 30u is unsigned int, 30l is long, 30ul is unsigned long. Like this we can define. So floating point literals. A floating point literal has an integer part, a decimal part, a fractional part, and an exponent part. You can represent floating point literals either in decimal form or exponential form. While representing decimal form, you must include the decimal point, the exponent, or both. And while representing exponential form, you must include the integer part, the fractional part, or both. The signed exponent is introduced by e, small e, or capital E. So this is the way we are representing. Okay, remaining all are illegal, right? So character constants, character literals are enclosed in single quotes. Example, this can be stored in a simple variable of character type. A character literal can be a plain character, an escape sequence, or a universal character. String literals. String literals are constants are enclosed in double quotes. A string contains characters that are similar to character literals, plain characters, escape sequences, and universal characters. You can break a long line into multiple lines using string literals and separating them using whitespace characters. Defining constants. There are two simple ways in C to define constants: using hash define preprocessor, using CONST keyboard. The hash define preprocessor given below is the form to use hash define preprocessor to define a constant. Hash define identifier name and value. And generally we can define, you can use CONST prefix to declare constants with a specific type as follows: CONST type variable is equal to value. So here hash define length is equal to 10, width is equal to 5. Whenever we are using length and width, automatically the values are replaced with 10 and 5. So here also it is not replaced, it will automatically come. So this is the way we define constants. Okay, in this topic we are discussing about what is variable and what is constants. Thank you.